It's a sales process that was designed in the 40s. Meet and greet, council qualify, selection, presentation, trial close, F&I. Weave right. through that, stay off price, slow them down. And it's almost laughable when you're selling to a millennial and they're being brought through that or trying to train a millennial salesperson on that. Their brains don't work that way. So what I'll point to is a couple of things. There's a bit of a sweet spot now, I would say around 50 minutes, where if you actually track the deals and the transaction in the showroom that are happening under an hour, if we have an average transaction time under an hour, and I'm still okay with salespeople taking 2 or 3 hours or 2 or 3 months to sell a car, because not everybody's ready to buy a car when they come in, but a lot of people are.
Right.
And some people literally will close in 15 or 20 minutes. But the only transactions where I was going with that 35% and then 36% off thing, besides all the information the client has, the transactions on average where the dealerships are making money on the front end and back end, the most money, are transactions that happen shorter on the front end, because the customer comes in pretty much transaction ready. We don't get in their way. We don't skip steps or speed things up, but you move right towards a close. There's obviously not a lot of time for objections. They obviously don't have a lot of questions. They're happy with whatever transaction price they saw online, maybe right. a little bit of an incentive, whatever that's going to be. And also for the F&I manager, who's going to deal with that customer generally after the person in the showroom, ask any business manager, would you rather be talking to a customer that spent 2, 3, 4 hours buying a car? Or would you rather have a customer in front of you now that's only been taking, half an hour to an hour buying a car? So all the metrics from profitability, customer satisfaction, closing ratios, and F&I improve when transaction times drop. And I really encourage my clients to, just start paying attention to that, because a lot of dealerships really are not cognizant and are not tracking transaction times. And it's one of the two most important metrics when I work with a client now that we pay attention to, that when we make a change in it, everything improves. Including employee retention. I mean, a salesperson would much rather learn how to sell a car in 45 minutes versus 2 or 3, 4 hours. That's how salespeople are built. And right now, with the way customers are, most of us in every business we go to equate customer experience and, a great, experience any place. And we say, what was so great about it? You say, they're so fast. It was so quick. It was so easy.
Right.
That's pretty much, if you think about any store we go to or go back into, and you say, oh, it's a great restaurant. Why? Because they're on it. They're on point. It's quick. So we've got to kind of start mirroring whatever his expectations are.
I love this because, what you just said is there's kind of this spill-off effect, right? You decrease transaction times. But I love what you're saying but we're also seeing increased employee retention. We're seeing...
Big time.
And that helps with morale and culture and all of these different things.
Right.
And so I think that's a really fascinating thing. So, I know there were those who were like, dude, why is Cirillo asking why we should this is a no brainer. But as you've pointed out, holy smokes, there's a lot more to the why of decreasing a transaction time than just the face value, because we all want things quickly.
Well, and I'm talking from experience. Like I said, we've been down this road now 3 to 5 years. I've got a dealer group in particular that's